Hey, hey, hello everyone, and welcome to this very new episode of my channel. My name is Leader, or Lider, however you wanna call me, and today we are back to Rezerwat Leśna Ostoja, so a collab between me and wonderful Mr. ZooF. So, in today's video we are going to build a giant, real giant barn in the center of our little reserve, which will be home to, I don't know, maybe not a home, but a shelter to cows and fallow deers, which Mr. ZooF added in the previous episode. And if you haven't checked that one out, there is a link, I think, in the description. Yes, there is a link in the description for sure, and there will be also a little link attached to the right top corner right now, popping up on the screen. And I think there will also be a link to a playlist on my channel where you can find every Rezerwat Leśna Ostoja episode from the very first to the very last. So, what are we starting with? Obviously, we are creating a custom, plank wall for our big barn, our big barn. And yes, as I said, it's custom and it's beyond custom, as for me, because I haven't really done anything like that before in my Planet Zoo journey and career. And as you can see, I wanted to make every of that planks different. I wanted to give it a little bit more style, I wanted a few of them to pop up a little bit more than the others, and I wanted everyone to look a little bit crappy, maybe not crappy, but a little bit older, like worn out, like, I don't know, with not very smooth and sharp edges. So that's what we did with usage of smaller planks sunk into the bigger planks to give that a little bit more of a texture. And the first part of this video was actually built before Europe Pack released, and yes, we'll talk about Europe Pack in a second, but I wanted to build it slightly in advantage, so I was doing it before the release, and I was waiting for the day when the Europe pack launches and I can build in Leśna Ostoja back again, because as you might know, ZooF had early access, and that's what didn't allow us to work on Leśna Ostoja in a pretty continue way. So right on the screen there is footage from Leśna Ostoja after the DLC launch. So as you could see, I didn't do a lot off screen, I didn't do like a giant blueprint. And now I'm experimenting a little bit with the decals and the new sticker pieces. They are absolutely great, and I wish I used them more in this project, because I haven't really used them for the base of this building as for now, because I didn't feel like they would fit that little bit of a cobblestone base. But I can assure you that I use them in the later stages of the video when we will build a little cow feeding area, and it was perfect to add. And yeah, I'm really happy with those pieces, and I'm really happy with the Europe pack in general, because as you might know, there is just a new Planet Zoo DLC, and it got released on the 14th of December, and it's called a Europe pack, and we are getting 5 new animals and a lot of pieces, and I'm sure 90% of you already have that pack, and if you do, I'm sure that you are simply amazed with it, because Frontier did such a good job on it, not only animals but building pieces. Oh my god, building pieces. The biggest problem I had last month was that there wasn't a new DLC with building pieces. I mean, this North American animal pack was great, don't get me wrong, I loved the animals, especially the moose and the Californian sea lion, but for me as a builder it wasn't that beneficial when it comes to content, because I couldn't build anything with the new pieces. And new pieces are what makes us content creators build more and to experiment with, because if we are bored with the pieces we already have, we don't want to build, basically. And I think it's the case with every player, because we need something new. I don't want to compare us to animals, but if a dog has a new toy, it is more likely to play with it other than this old toy. At least it's a case with my dog, which was presented in one of the research done episodes. But back to the subject, I think that, yeah, the building pieces are absolutely great. I love the metal pieces, and they remind me of Europe a lot. And I'm from Europe, I'm from Poland, basically. And obviously, basically. And yeah, the pieces feel like home. Maybe they were based on Italy, but some of the pieces are just as European as I could have imagined them to be, and the new hinges and new small pieces, new iron beams and all of that, they will be so useful in later stages of my planned zoo career, I think, because I'm not going to end making content for you guys. And yeah, I'm simply amazed with them, and I have experimented with them a lot, and I'm hoping to use them in the newest Research Done episode, which I haven't really started building yet. And I know production of Research Done episodes takes a lot of time, because first I need to do a research. Oh, I must say I did research already for the new species of Research Done, but then I need to build, and then comes editing. And editing takes so much time. It takes really much time, dear viewers, and that's why Research Done episodes aren't that as frequent as speed builds now of Rezerwat Leśna Ostoja. So, and to say there won't be a new Research Done episode before Christmas, because I still need to work a lot in Leśna Ostoja, and as we want with ZooF to finish it, and I know I'm repeating myself, I was talking about it in the last video, but we need to rush more, and need to constantly build in Rezerwat Leśna Ostoja to get it done for you to check out on Christmas. So, for Christmas, is there anything I can say about Christmas? On my Twitter I recently did a little picture of cookies, reindeer cookies I did for my family for Christmas, because I do them every year. And Mr. Leaf, I'm sure you know Mr. Leaf from Planet Zoo community, commented whether that was some sort of a magic that I do with pieces, and no, I would love to make such a cute little cookies in Planet Zoo, but I'm not able to, because yeah, we all know pieces in this game, and they are not as small as we would love them to be. I mean, maybe few of you don't want pieces to be that small, but never mind. As you can see, we skipped forward like, oh my god, it's like half of the video. No, maybe not, like, I don't know which part of the video it is, but we are doing a slightly custom roof, and in the first I wanted to, at first not, in the first, at in maybe in the first place, yes, maybe in the first place. In the first place I wanted to do this roof all custom with bamboo pieces, but then it didn't look right, so I decided on keeping that flexi-color clay roof in here, and then I will do some custom bamboo part of this roof, just for the sake of this little triangular part to look nice and to blend in with everything, because there is no such shape of roof piece as this little triangle on the top. And talking about the roof, I think it's the most Polish roof I could have ever imagined. And I introduced you to some of the Polish architecture, to the tilted planks, and now I'm introducing you to this sort of roof, and I think it's known all across the Europe, but I think it's really Polish, at least for me, and it is the second roof type I want to present you. And there will be also the third in the very next episode, so you can enjoy the nice bamboo custom roof. So, a lot to say, not very much time to say things. I mean, there is some time, because this video is about 26 minutes, I think, with 24 minutes of speed build, and it's the longest, because this is the biggest build I have ever done in Leśna Ostoja, so it needed just a little bit longer video. And as ZooF said in his last video, he's making like shorter videos, so you can watch them while doing something on your loo, like pooing or something. Yeah, that's gross, but I can't do that sort of videos, because ZooF builds so much faster, and he does utterly amazing things in like three times quicker than me. And I think I improved, and now my builds take me 2 days as this barn, not like 3 weeks as the Limpopo Painted Dog Conservation Center I also did for ZooF. So now on the screen we are doing few of these logs that will support the door, and that's the, yeah, that's another Polish thing we do here, because yeah, you need to, I don't know, safely ensure that your doors won't open, and that's why you use those poles, just a cheap way to keep them in place and prevent animals from escaping from the barn. And as you can see, the barn is just ginormous, and without this addition that is currently being brewed brewed on the screen. You know, you can brew potions in games like Minecraft or something, so we are now brewing something. I needed to make a little something so this barn doesn't look that humongous, because yeah, it was really humongous. And the backstory of this barn, as you can see, the color of this barn doesn't really match the color of the sheep barn that I did in the one of the first episodes, is that this barn was there for ages, and now it's considered a little relic, and it has its own inspector, and it's protected by law. So if you do want to do anything to this barn, you need to talk to this, to that inspector, you need to go with the law, you need to, yeah, satisfy thousands different requirements. So that's why this barn is untouched and it's still there. Maybe even if the owners of Rezerwat Leśna Ostoja wanted it to move or wanted it to be, I don't know, demolished, they can do that because that's protected by law, and yeah, it needs to be here. So yes, I wanted to say that, and also why this barn is so big. For like practical reasons, if for once upon a time it was used not only for cows and other inhabitants of this place, but also for like vehicles for farming, so that's why it's so big. And it was also used as storage, and what we are building now is a little crane, like medieval looking crane. And you won't see the full construction of this crane, the full construction. Yeah, I will only show you the first parts of its construction, with the little circle that is moving around and the little rope part. And then I think you will get to see the whole crane, because I don't know why I did that, but this crane is fully finished. I mean, at least in 70%. So you don't only have the part that you see from outside the barn, but I also made a thing that is... Oh, yes, now you can see it on screen. I did a whole crane, and I don't know why I did that. That was a total piece waste. But yeah, that's me, and don't even ask me why I did that. And as you can see, we skipped slightly more fast forward, and we have completed the back wall, like the side wall of the barn. And yes, the side wall of the barn was pretty much the same as the front. With I needed to elongate the planks slightly more, and that's why I didn't want you to watch it, because that's too repetitive and I don't think it's very nice to watch. Also, the thing I cut was the fencing in the actual cow enclosure that will come up in like a few minutes, because I didn't think that you will really appreciate that thing that much. Yeah, I think if you want the fencing here, yes, now you can see, yes, that's what you wanted, okay. So now back to the build. We are doing, yes, the backside of the barn, and I wanted this thing to be a centerpiece of the little main square that will come in here, but the problem is that the lighting in this game works in such a way that we can't move the sun. And I know, in real life you also can't move the sun, but I think this part being in the shadow all the time is so frustrating, because I wanted it to glow, I wanted to make, like, I don't know, custom crates here, so you would see how this crane in here would work in the medieval times, on like 90 years ago. But no, I can do that because it's always in shadow, and when it's at least a little bit of light in here, it's like pretty much evening, and yeah, evening is just the best time for for showing off how the crane work works in the whole project. And now, yes, I remembered correctly, we are doing the cow feeding show, not a show, but a cow feeding place. And if you have watched my latest Research Done episode, this can be classified as the secure feeder, because a keeper doesn't necessarily have the contact with animals, so he just puts the hay on one side, and the animals can stick their heads through the fence on the other side and eat without escaping or, I don't know, moving out to touch the guests. And talking about guests, guests always will have an opportunity to see how the cows eat, and I think, I don't know whether it's super exciting, but I would like to see a cow eat in such a petting zoo. So the guests can stand slightly further from the feeding place, separated by a little guest fence, and see how cows munch on their hay, and yeah, have a basically great time. There will be also me here trying to make this foot throw a little bit wider so I could place there the bedding for animals, so it looks like hay, but it was too big in the end and I decided on no bedding, no hay in at all, and pretend that it's not the feeding time, so we need to wait patiently and maybe tour other part of the reserve in the meantime. And so, I think I spoke a lot to you already, and I think it will be a nice time for me to say bye-bye to you and go do my things, because yeah, I'm still working in Rezerwat Leśna Ostoja, as I said, because we need to slightly more rush. And we have a few more exciting new things to come into this project, and I think I cut down the part when I'm looking to the little plan that I had drawn some time ago, and ZooF decided to put it on the custom billboard, custom image, so we can see and check on it whenever it's possible. But yes, so as I said, I wish you a very pleasant evening, I mean, because this this video debuts, premieres on evening, but if you are watching this in the morning, I wish you a very pleasant morning, and if you are watching this in the afternoon, then have a wonderful afternoon. So, thank you all for watching, consider liking, subscribing, maybe commenting, and speak to you in the next episode. Goodbye!